A very pleasant good morning to you, if it's morning where you are. In any event, greetings to you wherever you are, in any corner of this wonderful world that our God has made available to us. Thank you again for joining us at the Citadel Incorporated. Yes, we are in consecration and it is day 9. Thank you so much for those of you who have been with us from day 1. We understand that this is a consecration, it's a journey, and you can come on at any point. We are not even dictating to you what type of fast you may or you should have, whether it's full or partial, whether it's a juice fast. We are not doing that. We're leaving that to you and the Lord. But we here, when we speak, we are speaking of a full fast, meaning that you are going without food. And if you have to drink, then there are selective juices, for example 100% apple, 100% cranberry, 100% grape, not grapefruit juice, and herbal tea, not anything with caffeine in it, and of course as much water as possible. And so you feast on spiritual food where you would normally have natural food, and by now you should be feeling great. Your energy level should be heightened, both literally and spiritually. So thank you so much if you're on the journey. And before we move into our devotion this morning, in which we're going to have Minister Jacqueline James of Matters of the Heart sharing with us. That's a ministry that has been closely connected with the Citadel. But before we do that, I just want to issue a word of advice. I understand that since we are now at day 9, there may be some people who are thinking of, getting off the consecration fasting train, so to speak. If that is you, and we are not saying you should, we plan to go until the 20th of this month and leave it open to the 27th for those who come on late and who want to catch where we have been. So here is what I'm going to ask you to do. If and when you decide to break your fast, don't go eating heavy meals like your carbs right away. My advice is to start with vegetable broth, and little by little you may add a little more vegetables to it, and keep it in small portion. Drink as many times throughout the day as you want. Each day you add a little more to it and bring back your digestive system in line. One other thing I would advise you for your own physical health as well. Don't go back now that you've cleaned your house. Don't go back and put the garbage in it that will make you physically sick. This is a sermon for a later date, but be careful. If you have further questions, just email us or text us or message us. We'll be talking more about breaking the fast later on. But praise God that you are with us, and He's more than capable of keeping us on this journey and ministering His purpose even more in our lives. And so welcome, and we're going to turn right over now to Sister Jacqueline James of Matters of the Heart.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone. It's such a great day to be existing in the earth. And we will join with the psalmist this morning in Psalm 117 as he says, "Praise the Lord, all you nations. Extol him, all you peoples. For great is his love towards us, and his faithfulness endures forever." It's Jackie with Matters of the Heart, and it's that time again, time for devotion. Our devotion is entitled, "What Will You Choose to Believe?" And I will ask that of you again, my brothers and my sisters, what will you choose to believe today? A scripture lesson comes to us from Joshua 2 and 11, and it reads, "As soon as we heard these things, our hearts melted. Neither did there remain any more courage in anyone because of you. For the Lord your God, He is God in heaven above and on earth beneath. Now while the Israelites were calling those in Canaan giants, the hearts of those giants were melting in fear of the Israelites. Instead of listening to Joshua and Caleb, whose words filled the atmosphere with faith, they chose instead to suck all hope from their surroundings by listening instead to the other 10 spies who spoke only of their inability and their greatness and the greatness of their enemies. They even tried to repent when they realized what they had done and decided to try to obey God in taking the land, but it was too late. Their own words had already undone them. Now let us go into prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for being God and Master and ruler over our lives. We thank you for being the great I am. We thank you, mighty God, for being the same yesterday, today, and forever. We thank you, mighty God, for being the God who will always, always come to our rescue. And so, Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us absolute assurance that you are in total control of our lives. Father, we greet obstacles today with solid rock faith. And hallelujah, Jesus, we arise today knowing that you hear and answer our prayers. So, Father God, release the divine angelic escorts to safely lead us into godly places today and always. Father, the light of your word illuminates our path. And not only does it illuminate our path, mighty God, but it continues to guide us into greater places. Father, we thank you, mighty God, that by its principles, Father, we blaze new trails and defy the status quo. For Father God, we keep trusting and believing in you, that Father, you will allow us to discover new horizons within our chosen field. And so, Lord, I pray that you will order our steps today. Father, we seek to walk in step with you. Father, we remain in your perfect peace. Only, Father, because we put our trust in you and not in man. So, Heavenly Father, as we continue to go throughout this day, and even as we come to you, Father, asking that you navigate our path today, Father, I pray that you will allow us, Father God, to choose to believe you and you only, and to continue to put our trust in you, knowing, Father, that you are indeed the very author and the very finisher of our faith. And Father, we tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
And now, Father, we take authority over every plan, every ploy, every scheme, every trap, every arrow, everything that the enemy would seek to set up against your people. Now we take authority over it this very moment, and we do so in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ. We take authority over the plans that have been hatched by the enemy to take over and infiltrate the high places of God's people, their mind. And so this morning, we take every thought and put it into subjection, everyone that would seek to exalt itself above the things of the Spirit and of God. And so we say to our homes, into our hearts, into our souls, into our minds, into our spirits, that we do not have fear. We will not fear. For God, you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. And so right now, we use the power, the love, the sound mind, and your word that you have given us. We declare with your authority, with your power, but in the name of Jesus Christ, that our homes are purified, cleared, protected. We declare that our work environments are secured. And we declare that when we speak, we no longer speak selfishly from ourselves, but we speak as oracles of Jesus, who is the Christ. And now in the name of Jesus Christ, we speak to sicknesses, diseases, we cancel harm and danger. We speak peaceful, restful sleep in the name of Jesus to everyone who is on this line. And we speak that, Lord, your salvation, your glory, your power, your majesty, and your dominion will take fresh root in their homes, fresh root in their environment, in their working spheres of existence. And Lord, this morning we expel doubt. We cast down fear. We speak against every negative thought, every negative word right now. We cancel that. And we expel the dirt and the germs that the enemy would want to put in our spheres of existence. We cancel confusion and destruction in the name of Jesus Christ. Filthy words. Negative spirits. We cancel that, the thoughts and behaviors right now. And we expel them. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ over all our fears, over all our dreams, over all our ambitions, over the various ministries that have been connected. And now, Lord, we welcome your power. We welcome your peace. We welcome your glory. We welcome your healing. We welcome your divine providence. Yes, Lord, we welcome your strength. We welcome your power. And Lord, as we go on this journey, may we continue to decrease so that our spirit man is increased in you and that you can begin to speak more and more into all of our lives, all of our circumstances. And now for that person on our mind, we've been praying of God for healing for quite a while. And it's not that you have not heard the prayers, but this morning, in the name of Jesus, the Christ of Nazareth, we speak with your authority, even on this consecration. We speak a rising up of that sick bed. We speak unstopping of that deaf ear. We speak opening of blind eyes this morning. We speak healing from cancer, various forms and types, in the name of Jesus, because there is healing, there is power in that name. So Father, we thank you for your presence with us. We thank you for your power, and we thank you for the faith that you have caused us to have in you through the power of your Holy Spirit. Now, Lord, arise in all our spheres of existence. Let all the enemies of our time be scattered. Take over. For greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. We give you thanks, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory and we give you honor. In the name of Jesus, the Christ of Nazareth, who once taught us to pray and say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom. Yes, it is. The power, yes, the power is yours. And the glory, it has always been this way. It will always be this way, both now and forever. So we agree with your word and we say, Amen. God bless you. Stay on the journey.